नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम टू सेवेंथ लेक्चर ऑफ पॉलीनोमियल्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी एलजेब्रिक आइडेंटिटीज एंड सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 2.5। नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट इज एन एलजेब्रिक आइडेंटिटी। एन एलजेब्रिक आइडेंटिटी इज एन एलजेब्रिक इक्वेशन दैट इज ट्रू फॉर ऑल वैल्यूज ऑफ वेरिएबल्स ऑकरिंग इन इट। नाउ लेट अस understand this with the help of one identity. So first identity we will see is x plus y the whole square. This is equals to x square plus 2xy plus y square. Now if you see the statement, an algebraic identity is an algebraic equation. So here you can see that this is an algebraic equation that is true for all values of variable occurring in it. And this is true for all variables that is occurring in it. Now you take any value of x and y on left hand side and right hand side, you will get the same result for any value of x and y. So this is an identity. So identity is an algebraic equation which is true for all values. Now this identity you have learned in your lower standard. So here we are going to see few identities which you already know, and we will add few more identities. Now you can prove these identities. This is very simple. For example, if I want to prove this identity, what I will do? I will multiply x plus y by x plus y, as it is x plus y the whole square, and I simplify it. I will get expression as x square plus 2xy plus y square. Now let us see the second identity, x minus y the whole square. It is x square minus 2xy plus y square. So here if you compare them, so here there is a change of sign of y, and similarly in the expression there is a change in sign of 2xy. Now let us see the third identity. Third identity is x square minus y square. This is x plus y into x minus y. Fourth identity is x plus a into x plus b equal to x square plus a plus b times x plus ab. Now here if you see this fourth identity, the first term in both the expressions is same. Here it is x plus a, here it is x plus b. Only the second term is different in both the cases. So what we are doing, we are taking square of first term which is x here, then plus sign we are giving, and then we are adding these two terms, that is a and b, and multiplying it with x, and finally we are adding last two terms, and this is how we are getting x plus a into x plus b. Fifth identity is x plus y plus z the whole square. This is x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. Now here first three terms are square of these three terms which is x, y and z, and the other three terms are two times. I have taken two term at a time. So first I have taken xy, then I have taken yz, and then we have taken xz or zx. So this is x square plus y square plus z square plus 2 times xy plus 2 times yz plus 2 times xz or zx. Identity number 6 is x plus y the whole cube. This is x cube plus y cube plus 3xy in bracket x plus y. So again we have taken the cube of first term plus cube of second term plus 3 times x into y into in bracket it is x plus y. Now if I open this bracket, I will get 3x square y plus 3xy square. So I will also write this expression as x cube plus 3x square y plus 3xy square plus y cube. Now how you can remember this? So first we have written x cube, then 3 times we have decreased the power of x from 3 to 2, and we have add y term. You can also consider that in the first term y power 0 is there. y power 0 is 1, so it is not written. Now the power of y is increasing and the power of x is decreasing. The next term is 3 into x, so we have decreased power once more and then we have increased the power of y, so y square, and finally we have decreased the power of x, so there is no x term and we have y cube. So x cube plus 3x square y plus 3xy square plus y cube. Or you can say that x plus y the whole cube is x cube plus y cube plus 3xy into x plus y. This expression is little easy to learn rather than this expression, but you should remember both of the expressions. Now seventh identity is x minus y the whole cube is x cube minus y cube minus 3xy end bracket x minus y. Now wherever there is odd power of y, we have taken negative sign. So here we have taken negative sign, here we have taken negative sign, and here also we have taken negative sign. As here the power of y is 1, here the power of y is 1, here the power of y is 3, odd term. Now if we open this bracket, we will get x cube minus 3x square y plus 3xy square minus y cube. So in this expression also you can see that wherever the power of y is odd, we have taken negative sign. And finally we have 8th identity, which is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz gives me x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. Now here again this is simple to learn. First we have written x plus y plus z, then x square plus y square plus z square, so square of each term, and then minus of, we have taken two term at a time, that is xy, yz and zx. Now in case x plus y plus z is 0, so this whole right hand side will become 0 because 0 multiplied by anything is 0, and we get x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is 0, or I will say that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equals to 3 times xyz. Now this property that when x plus y plus z is 0, x cube plus y cube plus z cube is 3xyz is very very important. All the identities you can prove by proper expansion of your left hand side. Now what I recommend that you pause video here, you again go through all the 8 identities, then try to write all the identities without looking at the answer. Right? Okay. Now once you've done these identities, we will move to the problems of exercise 2.5. Now first problem is use suitable identities to find the following product. The first question is x plus 4 into x plus 10. We have to use suitable identity and expand it. So we have already seen one identity, that is x plus a into x plus b. The expression is x square plus in bracket we have a plus b plus a into b. So we will use that thing. First we write x square plus we add these two terms, that is 4 and 10 into x, then we multiply this 4 and 10. Now after simplification this gives me x square plus 14x plus 10 4s are 40. So this is my expansion of x plus 4 into x plus 10. I hope this you understand. We have used identity of x plus a into x plus b equal to x square plus a plus b times x plus ab. Now we will see few more problems based on this identity, right? So let us see the second question. This is x plus 8 into x minus 10. So again the second term, which is b, here is minus 10 and a is plus 8. So no worry, we are going to use the same identity. So what I will write, first I will write x square plus I add these two terms, that is 8 and minus 10 into x, then 8 into minus 10. So this will give me x square minus 2x minus 80. I hope you are getting. Yes. Okay. Now the third question is 3x plus 4 into 3x minus 5. Now see, this first term is 3x. So what I will write? I will write 3x the whole square plus in bracket I will write 4 minus 5 into 3x. So first term is 3x, so in place of x we are writing 3x plus 4 into minus 5. Again we have used the identity that x plus a into x plus b is x square plus in bracket a plus b times x plus ab. This will give me answer as 9x square. This on simplification gives me minus 3x, and this is minus 20. So it is 9x square minus 3x minus 20. Now let us see this fourth problem. Here it is of the form of x plus y into x minus y. So x plus y into x minus y is x square minus y square. So we write this as y square the whole square minus 3 by 2 the whole square. That will give me y power 4 minus 9 upon 4. Now fifth problem, 3 minus 2x into 3 plus 2x. Again, this is in the form of a plus b into a minus b, or you can write that as a minus b into a plus b. Your answer will be a square minus b square. So here we have 3 square minus 2x the whole square. That will give me 9 minus 4x square. So these problems are based on few identities which we have seen on the first page. Now second question, first problem is I have to evaluate the product 103 into 107. I don't have to multiply them directly, I have to use identities. So 103 into 107, what we can write? 103 into 107, we can write this as 100 plus 3 into 100 plus 7. Now this is of the form of x plus a into x plus b. So x plus a into x plus b is x square plus in bracket we have a plus b into x plus ab. So we will use that identity, and here we get 100 square plus 3 plus 7 times 100 plus 3 into 7. That will give me 10,000. Two zeros are there, so in our answer there is 4 zeros. Plus 10 into 100, that will give 1000 plus 21. So the final answer is 11,021. Now next question, 95 into 96. Now you tell me, how you write 95 into 96? Will you write it as 90 plus 5 into 90 plus 6, or there is another way? So either you write 90 plus 5 into 90 plus 6, or else here you can write as 100 minus 5 into 100 minus 4. Now this is little easy, because whenever 10 or 100 or 1000 is involved, it is easy to find their squares and their multiples. So here again we are going to use the identity of x plus a into x plus b, that is x square plus a plus b times x plus ab. So here it is 100 square plus minus 5 minus 4 into 100 plus minus 4 into minus 5. So that will give me 10,000 minus 900 plus 20, and finally I'll get the answer as 9,120. Third question is 104 into 96. Now this 104 into 96 we can write as 100 plus 4 into 100 minus 4. So you are seeing that always we are trying to take one term as 10 or 100 like that. Again here it is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. So here I have 100 square minus 4 square. That will give me 10,000 minus 16. So it is 9,984. Now let us move to third question. First problem is 9x square plus 6xy plus y square. We have to factorize using appropriate identities. So here it is of the form of a square plus 2ab plus b square, or x square plus 2xy plus y square, and your answer for this is x plus y the whole square. Now the identities which we have seen in the beginning, that you have to learn in both the ways. Like x plus y the whole square you learn as x square plus 2xy plus y square, and the similar way you should learn that x square plus 2xy plus y square is x plus y the whole square. So here if you see, the first term is square of 3x, so I will write 3x square, plus this 6xy I can write as 2 into 3x into y, and this y square I will write as y square. So this is of the form of a square plus 2ab plus b square. So my final answer is a plus b, that is 3x plus y the whole square, and that gives me answer as 3x plus y into 3x plus y. Let us see the second question. 4y square minus 4y plus 1. So here we are going to use identity as a square minus 2ab plus b square. So the first term is square of 2y. So 2y square minus 2 into 2y into 1 plus 1 square. So this will give me answer as 2y minus 1 the whole square. So this is 2y minus 1 into 2y minus 1. Third question is x square minus y square upon 100. So this is of the form of a square minus b square. So this is x square minus this is y upon 10 the whole square. So here a square minus b square is a plus b into a minus b. So we get as x plus y upon 10 into x minus y upon 10. So in this lecture we will see these three questions only, and in the next lecture we will see other problems. So again, revise the identities, solve all the problems. Thank you.